Hey guys, it's Dr. Wes Doss with Kiber, and kind of a question. Saw on the news tonight a news bulletin coming out of the city of Austin, Texas, that Austin PD universally across the board are getting rid of their duty belts because of back injuries, and every patrol officer is going to be carrying a load-bearing vest, which means that the pistol is going to come off the hip and going to go up on top of the vest someplace. Even though we know that the vast majority of our back injuries are attributed to sitting on our ass as much as we do in a vehicle, as opposed to what the belt actually does to us. This has taken a gun out of a normal hip presentation and putting it back into a cross draw presentation, which is gonna complicate things a little bit, in my opinion, when it comes back to firearms training and prepping these guys. Plus, it's putting it up where it's gonna become a retention issue potentially. Now, standing here, over the fire, we just finished some bourbon and some cigars, is a good friend of mine, George Brown, and between the two of us, we've got about, close to 60 years of law enforcement experience, which makes us sound like we're ancient. But what do you think about that, George?
Well, I can see a few issues aside from just the potential for pointing your own gun at yourself on a draw. You also have the issue of retention, where while you're dealing with a suspect, You're presenting your gun in a position where a simple reach and grab could potentially expose your firearm.
It's right there. Yeah, it's right up front.
Exactly. You have potential for somebody just grabbing your gun off your chest. Yes, I realize we all go through defensive tactics training, but you do have a retention issue as far as a suspect removing it from you. Like I said, I also have a problem with the pointing the gun at yourself, but you also have the problem contact and cover. If you have a cover officer that's anywhere near you at the time that you're contacting somebody and you go to draw your pistol, you just flag your own partner as you're drawing that pistol off of your chest.
Well, part of the problem, if not a significant part of the problem, is, I mean, the old saying used to be the longer you were on the job, the less crap you had on your belt.
Correct.
And now we've got so much shit, for all intents and purposes, that have been added to our duty belt and our body. How much crap are we going to stack on a load-bearing vest, and how much of it is going to have to be piled to the front just to make it accessible?
Well, you bring up another point, and that's you put your pistol up here on the right side or on the left side of your chest. Now you put your first aid kit and other equipment on there. How is that going to detract from your being able to draw that pistol effectively without catching it on other equipment when you're trying to remove it from its holster?
Yeah, absolutely. So I see it as a Band-Aid solution to a problem that is a much bigger problem that nobody wants to address. The sedentary existence behind the wheel of a vehicle, sitting on our ass as much as we do, and then the lack of physical fitness standards that exist amongst most law enforcement agencies.
Correct.
So I see it as a problem that hasn't really had a solution. It's kind of the wrong direction, I think. So what do you all think?